I'm not ashamed to own my Lord, nor to defend his cause. Maintain the honors of his word, the glory of his cross.
Hello, I'm James Brown, and on behalf of the Eastern Church of Christ located in Toronto, Canada, I'd like to welcome you to today's edition of Walking Through the Bible, a podcast where we seek to study the Bible and the Bible alone. Please stick around afterwards for information on how you can contact us. But for now, please go to the book of Genesis and we'll turn you over to Jeremy Dieselkamp for our study of the day.
Thank you, James, and welcome to all of our viewers. This is the 137th lesson in our study of Genesis. Yesterday we covered Genesis chapter 40 verses 1 to 15, discussing the dream of Pharaoh's cupbearer. If you missed that episode and would like to watch it, you can find it and all of our other podcasts on our website at www.eastendchurch.org. You can also find them on our YouTube channel at www.youtube.com/Eastend Church of Christ under the Walking Through the Bible Genesis playlist. Today we're going to begin with Genesis 40 verse 16 and read through verse 23. The text that you'll see on the screen is from the English Standard Version, but you're welcome to follow along with any version that you have. So let's now read Genesis 40, beginning at verse 16. When the chief baker saw that the interpretation was favorable, he said to Joseph, "I also had a dream. There were three cake baskets on my head. In the uppermost basket, there were all sorts of baked food for Pharaoh. But the birds were eating it out of the basket on my head." And Joseph answered and said, "This is its interpretation. The three baskets are 3 days. In 3 days, Pharaoh will lift up your head from you and hang you on a tree. And the birds will eat the flesh from you." On the 3rd day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, he made a feast for all his servants and lifted up the head of the chief cupbearer and the head of the chief baker among his servants. He restored the chief cupbearer to his position, and he placed the cup in Pharaoh's hand. But he hanged the chief baker as Joseph had interpreted to them. Yet the chief cupbearer did not remember Joseph, but forgot him. In this chapter, we find Pharaoh's 2 servants in prison with Joseph, each having a dream. Neither knew what their dream meant, but Joseph, trusting that God could interpret their dreams, asked both the chief cupbearer and the chief baker to tell him their dreams. The chief cupbearer went first and told him his dream. Joseph interpreted that the dream meant that in 3 days the chief cupbearer will be restored to his former position by Pharaoh. With that being the case, Joseph took the opportunity to ask the cupbearer to remember him when he returned to Pharaoh, seeing as how he was innocent of the crimes he was accused of. Note here that Joseph didn't blame Potiphar for not digging deeper into his wife's accusations, nor did he even blame Potiphar's wife for lying. He simply pled innocent and asked the cupbearer to tell Pharaoh this. Now, seeing that the cupbearer's dream had a favorable interpretation, this cheered up the baker. So he now eagerly told Joseph his dream. That always seems to be human nature. If we're expecting news, say from our boss, and our coworker gets good news, like a raise, we'll then assume that we'll get the same news. Now this might be true, but it isn't necessarily true. The baker had no reason to assume that his dream would have a favorable interpretation, seeing as how it was a different dream. Nonetheless, the chief baker revealed his dream to Joseph. He said that he saw 3 cake baskets on his head, and in the top basket were all sorts of food baked for Pharaoh, but the birds were eating out of this basket. Unfortunately for the baker, Joseph's interpretation wasn't as favorable. Like with the chief cupbearer, the 3 baskets represented 3 days. In 3 days, the Pharaoh would lift up the baker's head and hang him on a tree. The birds of the air would then eat his flesh. Now I'm sure the baker hoped against hope that Joseph was wrong, but in 3 days was Pharaoh's birthday. He threw a party and lifted up the heads of the chief cupbearer and the chief baker, though in different ways. The chief cupbearer was restored to his position, while the chief baker was hanged. Events transpired just as Joseph said, which was only so because God revealed to Joseph the interpretations. This reminds me of Daniel 5:21, which says, "The Most High God rules the kingdom of mankind and sets over it whom he will." We're reminded that even though God gives us free will, he also can bring about events he sees fit in order to accomplish his purpose. We may not always understand his purpose, but let's rest assured that if God wills something to happen, it will happen. However, this chapter ends on a sad note, for we read that the chief cupbearer forgot Joseph. We don't know why this happened. Perhaps it was God's providence, but we simply don't know why it happened. It is a lesson to us, though, that if we promise something to someone, we'd better keep that promise, for our word should be our bond. However, just as before, God had not forgotten Joseph, something we will find out, the Lord willing, on Monday. With that, our time is up for today. Please join us, the Lord willing, tomorrow for the question and answer edition, as well as the weekly sermon edition of this podcast. This week's question is, can I just pray and be saved from my sins? Well, the sermon will be titled, What is the Bible Really Saying? We will continue our study of Genesis, the Lord willing, on Monday, beginning at Genesis 41, verse 1.
Thank you, Jeremy. And to our viewers, we also thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on the subscribe button below. Should you have any questions or comments, please leave them below or email them to answeringtheword@gmail.com. We'll try to respond to you as quickly as we can. We hope you'll join us, Lord willing, tomorrow for our weekly question and answer edition, as well as the weekly sermon edition of this podcast. Goodbye for now, and have a great day.
I'm not ashamed to